back, fanboys. We're here with another reaction video, and if you're new to the channel, welcome to Peerless Recordings. Go ahead, do yourself a favor, hit that subscribe button right now, tap that notification bell so you can be notified when we drop new content here on the channel. We're so happy you're with us. Today we're going to do NF Wake Up from the song from the album Mansion. This has been highly requested, been kind of scattering, broadening the horizons a little bit. We do have a ton of NF videos in the closet. Check them out on the playlist section. It's NF Reaction Videos. Today we're going to get into NF Wake Up. Real and raw here. You know how we do on the station. Let's get it done. Uh-oh. Looks a little bit...
Spend your life in a dream that you can't escape.
Ah. Can if you choose, but I hear you.
'Cause you live your life in a coma, you never awake.
Ooh, living a dream, and you can't escape, and you live in a coma that you can't awake from. That's tough, man, because sometimes that coma can be one of those things that just absolutely gear you down into a place that's tough to dig out of.
If you'd open your eyes, then maybe you'd see what's at stake.
That's a fact right there.
You're sleeping. You make a lot of money and you live in a mansion and pretty much got everything that you could ever imagine. But you feel like even though you got everything in the world, you got nothing. So what you do then is you start going backwards. You run in a direction and you looking for something that isn't real. And all you know is that you just gotta have it. What you doing is sleeping and thinking that you're awakening not. And the problem is that you don't know what you're after. So you...
That's tough, man. I want to go back right there because that's a big statement. Listen carefully.
Going backwards, imagine, but you... You make a lot of money and you live in a mansion and pretty much got everything that you could ever imagine.
So you live in a mansion and you make a lot of money and you could have everything that you've ever imagined.
But you feel like even though you got everything in the world, you got nothing. So what you do then is you start going backwards.
See, so then you think that those types of things in your mansion, the monetary things, are going to fulfill needs and plug in for voids that are in your life. And then you realize that that can't happen, man, that things are not going to make you happy. Options and opportunities and material things are all cool, but if you are not happy inside, those things are not going to make you happy. And then he's saying, now you're going to start going backwards.
You run in a direction and you looking for something that isn't real. All you know is that you just got to have it.
Now you're running into to a direction where people are going where you think like you don't know, but you just gotta have it. Come on now.
You're doing is sleeping and thinking that you're awakening not, and the problem is that you don't know what you're after. So you put everything that you have into what you do, hoping that one day maybe you don't have to feel like you're empty. But as you get older, a lot of weight in your shoulders is getting heavy. Then you look back and you start to regret things. You only get one life, and every time you look into yours, you feel like everything you have is a waste. And the problem and the reason you can never feel the whole of your life is because you were never awake.
Wow, he said you can't fill that void because you are not awake, man. You're not in that place where you need to be. You're still sleeping thinking that all this stuff that you're after is going to take care of that happiness void that's inside of you. And if you know anything about life, the goal in life is to be happy. Be happy, not spend your whole life worrying about everybody else being happy or spend your whole life giving of yourself. You know, and I'm not saying that those things aren't great because you should give of yourself at times with the expectation of nothing in return. But the fact is you have to be happy. It's your life. You get one. You're the only person that's going to be in your casket. You got to make the most of it while you're here.
And the problem and the reason you can never feel the hole in your life is because you were never awake. You spend your life in a dream that you can't escape.
Ah.
You live your life in a coma, you never awake.
I love that simple piano. I wonder if he's talking about just what she did or she's into something or doing something in her life that she, it caused her to lose her son or husband. Man, that's terrible.
Wake up. But feel like you never got up and go to work, and you're feeling like you ain't got a purpose. And you're trying to get motivated, but everything you do turns into a mess, like you ain't nothing but worthless. And yo, you look around, a lot of these other people you looking at, to you, you describe as perf. So you point a finger at God and tell him to do his job and fix your life up, cause nothing is working.
That's deep right there. You know, you feel like sometimes like your purpose on this earth is jaded, or you don't even understand, or you question the things about the earth and life, and why are we actually here? Are we just here to figure out how to survive? And, you know, are we just, you know, filled with luxury because we live in a place with freedom and opportunity? And or are you just unhappy at the core, and regardless of what it is that you're involved in, and you blame it on God and try to say, God, come on now. God, come on now. All I ever wanted was this. This is just one life I get. Don't I just get to have what I want? Just even one thing? And you turn to God and you blame him for things, and you ask him for things, and it's tough, man, because he has to allow free will to take place in your life, or faith does not exist. It's that simple. You cannot have faith in something you cannot see if you don't have free will. He can't dictate your life. You have to genuinely believe in him with your heart, mind, and soul, and he knows your heart. You can't just say, well, I'll just say I'm a Christian, so I'm a follower of Jesus Christ, so therefore I get what I want. Ready? Go. That doesn't work that way. Come on.
So you point a finger at God and tell him to do his job and fix your life up, cause nothing is working. And you would try to hide it and make it seem like it's nothing, but really you feel like everything is crashing around you. And you developed a problem in trusting in other people, which later became an issue that would mentally pound you.
Trust is a tough, tough thing. It's not just, you know, people think it involves relation, you know, just your primary relationship with whoever your significant other is, or the person, your domestic partner, whatever it is that you're involved in, I don't know. But the bottom line is your happiness and your purpose have to come from within. You have to have a connection to God to be able to do that. You cannot rely on trusting other people or other situations or environments to make you happy. You have to figure it out what it is that you need in your life to be happy.
And you developed a problem in trusting in other people, which later became an issue that would mentally pound you.
Facts.
You only get one life, but every time you look into yours, you feel like all you ever see are mistakes. And the problem and the reason you can never move forward in life is because you were never awake.
You see all these things in your life and you go, man, I'm at where I'm at because of the mistakes I made. So the reason I can't move forward is because I keep living in this facade, this place where, you know, reality doesn't exist. I just go and hide, and I say, hey, I don't know what to do with my life. I messed up so many times. There's things that are just unforgivable and irrevocable and irreplaceable, and I just can't go. And you know what? Everything I just talked about in reference to someone's life is all in the past. What can you do about it? Nothing but change. It's called turning away from the things that were hindering you and moving forward into a place or a situation that would help you. I call it ridding and replacing. Rid the things in your life that are in your way and replace them with things that are going to benefit you. People, places, opportunities, jobs, whatever it is.
Mistakes. And the problem and the reason you can never move forward in life is because you were never awake. Wake up.
You spend your life in a dream that you can't escape. Yeah. Cause you live your life in a coma, you're never awake.
I'll tell you right now, the things that you accumulate and the things that you think are going, when I get to this point in my life, I'll be all good and I'll be all happy and I'll be all okay. Is that so? Do you get? Is there a point in life where you go, okay, well, I've reached level 51 of life, and I'm ready to do this because I have accumulated this, and then someone else, well, I've reached level 17. I'm all set. No. The reality is all this stuff that you worry about accumulating, all these jobs and all this money that you put as the primary focus of your life, all means nothing in the bigger scheme. What happens? What happens if something happens to you? What happens to that stuff? Never ever seen a hearse pulling a U-Haul so you could take it with you, right? So reality, put that stuff in perspective, because you have to be mentally strong and emotionally strong, and you need to be healthy in all the dimensions of our spiritual, emotional, mental, physical, all those things we need to be healthy in before we start worrying about stuff. Stuff are add-ons. That's it. You know what that reminds me of? I don't know if you guys have ever heard of the band Casting Crowns, but they are so, so good when it comes to bringing real-life things to the forefront of people's minds. If you get a chance, listen to the song called Broken Together and watch the video. This reminds me of that a little bit, where these people turn in age and, you know, you realize, man, when your life is up, how have you spent it? How will you be remembered? What things will people stand up and say about you at your funeral? It's a big eye-opener. Big, big eye-opener. I've been at some funerals before. I've done some funerals before where the primary focus has been on things that just don't matter. And they didn't have anything else to talk about because they really didn't do anything significant with their life. They just did what they did, went to work every day, came home, fixed this, fixed that, went to bed, yada, yada. Well, they were part of the almighty Buffalo Bills Club since 1971. They had luxury seats in the 40 whatever. Ain't going to get you nowhere, man. Ain't going to get you nowhere. So that being said, hey, if you like the content here, man, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Go ahead and hit that notification bell. Give me that fat thumb up. Leave a comment and let us know how we did, and we'll be back with the next video. Peace.